The goal when we put the gantries up was to be, quote, revenue neutral. Which, given the fact that the volume isn't always exactly the same and that people change their patterns based on where the gantries were versus where the toll booths were, is a little complicated. But I think, I mean, I'll get you the exact numbers, but I think generally speaking, it has turned out to be a mostly revenue neutral play. I mean, one of the interesting things that happened when the gantries went up and the commute got easier, there's a whole bunch of people, you know, Waze just redefines the way everybody drives, right? So a whole bunch of people who were on side streets and surface roads suddenly came on to came onto the turnpike.
The Ludlow to Springfield route.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Right.
Yeah, because one of the things with that is just the, you know, the idea, I think we're interested in, do people who are out of state pay?
I think the answer to that for sure, yes. Yeah. Do you mean coming from New York?
Well, I know they have to pay, but do they actually pay?
Let's get an answer to that one.
Sure.
Yeah. I think that's a really good question.
Other states have had trouble. It becomes so expensive to collect.
It's hard to collect.
That some of them don't even try that hard to do that.
Okay, I would like to know the answer to this one too.
You know, especially if it's a, you know, that would be if it's an 80-cent toll or something like that.
I would like to know the answer to that. I mean, we do have statutory requirements on what we can spend and what we can raise based on where we are on the turnpike, and I know people abide by those because. That's a requirement. There's a report that gets submitted on that every year. But I'll ask about that one.
Yeah, I would think that most of the people in state, you know, they're going to get
frequent
found
flyers
out.
Too. People who use it a lot. I mean,